I'm going to show you how to sharpen images using the high pass filter. Sharpening images is not to be confused with having an image out of focus and bringing it back to focus. Let me show you. Before you publish an image online or in print, you should sharpen it. In order to work non-destructively, we're going to start by duplicating our background. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcuts Command J or Control J on Windows. I'm going to rename this layer Sharpen. To make this even more editable, I'm going to convert this to a smart object. When we convert layers to smart object, we apply smart filters, which means we can edit them later. I'm going to right click and choose Convert to Smart Object. Then go to Filter in the menu, down to Other and choose High Pass. The default value is 10, but what we want to do here is actually bring the radius to the lowest value. And when we do that, as you can see, everything in the image disappeared. And what we're looking for here is the texture coming through this gray layer. I'm going to gradually increase the image, and as you can see here, as I'm increasing the value, more of the texture is coming through. And what you're looking for is the point where you have all the texture coming through without bringing through all of the colors. I'm going to click OK to that, and we still have color here. It's not very obvious, but we are going to remove it. So just go to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation. If I increase the saturation, you can see that there is a lot of color left in the image. Sometimes that color can actually work in our favor, and having converted our layer to a smart object, we will have the option to bring that color back later. But if you want to sharpen an image without affecting your colors, you need to desaturate it first. So take the saturation to -100, click OK, and then finally what we're going to do is change the blend mode of the layer from normal to overlay. Now if you take a look at the layers panel here, you can see it looks a little bit different to normal, and that's because we have now got these effects that we applied as smart filters. And if we wanted to change one of these values, we can simply double click the title. You'll get this little message that basically says that it can't show all the effects added together while you're changing the settings, but that won't make any difference. So I would recommend you tick that box saying don't show again. And as you can see here, I could change the value higher or lower depending on my preference, and then click OK. And as I said to start with, there are a number of different ways of sharpening images, but this is my preferred method, both for images on screen or in print.